What's going on, guys, and welcome back to Northern Valley. It's been a little while since we were back in Northern Valley, and that's for reasons. I mean, if you follow me on Twitter, you know some stuff this week has been going on. So, yes, if you don't follow me on Twitter, the link is in the description, as always. But anyway, we have some work to do in this episode, and of course, I want to do a little bit of live building later on, so we'll get into that later on in the video, like I said. Anyway, this what we're doing right now is building a little service plaza over here next to, well, it's in Walton Ridge, but it's going to be servicing both Walton Ridge and Evergreen Park areas. I started building this, and I thought this was going to be like a small town kind of thing, and then I ended up putting down a lot of the bigger buildings around here, like the big fire department you see there, hospital and police department, of course. And yes, so I figured this will probably service more than just the very small, like, two development township that is Walton Ridge at this point. And I say two development because the one that we did already is there, and then the other one is behind this service plaza, and that goes in this episode, although we don't really build anything yet because we don't have the demand. You can see down there the demand that we have right now is mostly for commercial, and we have not really placed any of that beside what we had in the Rico. So yes, we do need to work on that, and we do have the area built for that, and you'll see that later in the time lapse. But yes, what I'm doing right now behind the firehouse, I decided to like not just have a little roundabout with another roundabout behind the hospital. I wanted to do something a little bit more. So behind the firehouse, I decided to put some sort of like little service garage. You can kind of see me here trying to find a little garage asset to plop down. And I think the bigger building right now that I just placed a fire truck down next to is actually a stable, but it works as a garage. And then we have that other small garage there anyway. And I detail it out with a little bit of old asphalt, concrete, something like that. But anyway, we made this little area behind here to be kind of like the service center for like municipal vehicles. So I placed a couple of them that were probably in service, and then some more over here that are waiting to be in service. And I placed a salt truck, even though this isn't a winter map. And then I decided to put this whole little road maintenance department right here, just to kind of fill out this space. So yes, I intended this to be really like a small thing, like I said, but it came out to be this huge thing that can probably service a lot of the what we have done already. Oh, I should mention that in between episodes, I did go back and detail the guitar pick interchange, I think we called it. So I will show you that in the live portion. Hopefully I remember to, but anyway. So yeah, I'm just going through here and finishing up this little service plaza, doing some detail work. I haven't been doing detail work, I think it's been a couple episodes since I've done some detail work, but yeah, I went through and I actually detailed this area, and I think it comes out really nice. You saw me before try to place some of the parking lots down, and I actually grabbed a bunch of them off of the Steam Workshop, but some of them just aren't working for whatever reason. I don't know if I didn't download the right like decal or little texture thing or whatever. But yeah, there's an issue currently, and I have to look into that and why that's happening. But yeah, some of the parking lots are actually really cool, but I just couldn't place them down. So I'm hoping to be able to do that in the future, but yes. Anyway, you'll notice in between those two shots right there, the color correction changed. And that's because I had actually gotten quite a few comments from you guys about it looking a little washed out. And I thought it didn't look that bad. But I mean, looking back at it, it really was washed out, and I was kind of going for that feel because it is supposed to be like a northern city or region, really. But this does look a lot different. I don't know if it's better or not. I think it is. I do believe it looks a lot better, but you guys can let me know if you don't like it. We could always go back. And also the map theme that I'm using, it got updated, so there's a different water texture now, I think, and a few other little tweaks. So that's something to kind of keep your eyes on, I guess, in passing. But yeah, I really like, I didn't get a chance to really talk about it, but those rocks that I put out in front of this, I really like how those look, and you'll actually see that in the interchange area that I went through and finished up. But yeah, I really like how that looks, and I really like that grass next to it, or in and around it. It's really, it gives it a little bit more of like a good thing. I didn't want to just put like more trees in between the road and the service plaza. I wanted to do something a little bit more than that, and this really did fit. Although I do need to go in and actually grab some more monuments and stuff to put in between stuff, because I mean, we've been using a lot of these conifers. I think that's how you pronounce that. These trees, these like pine tree looking things, those have been all over the place. And I kind of want to start to veer away from that just a little bit, even though it's still going to be a main staple. You can see me putting them down right now. But yeah, it's still a main staple of this region just because of, I guess, how they would be growing in the natural space around it, I guess. I don't know how to explain this, but anyway, you'll see me right now smoothing out this area. That's the next thing that we're going to work on. Well, not in the time lapse, but in the live portion, we're going to be working on that area, because I did do a little bit in toward the end of this. But right now, we are going through and placing another development throughout here, another winding little development. And you'll see that I really wanted to wind this around this little area. This is kind of like a hillside. Most of these things over here are a hillside. We're still building in some really rough terrain. So, I don't know. The city does get a lot flatter, more in toward where we're gonna actually build a city. So I'm looking forward to that. But right now we just kind of have to work around it. So I'm doing a lot of terraforming, and I really don't want to be doing as much terraforming that I have been. But we have to get certain things done, like that service plaza. But anyway, I wound that main road on this development around a lot, and that was by design. I didn't want to cut it straight around because I didn't want cars to be taking that as opposed to that main six-lane road. I needed to make the route longer so cars would take the main road over just having like a shortcut. So that's kind of why I did that. And it should work, and I think it does. I've been kind of monitoring it, so we haven't had anybody really going through it. But anyway, this over here, you saw me put a bridge down right then, and that was because I want to go and make that kind of like a highway on-off ramp later on for when we expand more that way and into the Evergreen Park District, the new Evergreen Park District. But anyway, you'll see me put these parking lots down now, and I was really trying to find them. A lot of them are really cool, and we'll be able to do a lot with them, but I couldn't find, well, some of them just didn't work, like I said before, but yeah, like I said, I gotta figure that one out. I did find these really cool, like, 1x6 parking lots, so I decided this is gonna be a really cool little main square area, and I have this three-lane, one-way street, and it goes around, and I adjust it all right there, but this is gonna be, like, the central park area, parking, maybe, is a better way to put it, but yes, my vision for this area is we're going to have commercial all around this, and it's going to be really cool because it's going to, one, satisfy the commercial, and two, give people from these districts a place to go and shop, because currently they have that Walmart up the street, but this, in my mind, is going to be more of like a boutique area, so like mom and pop type stuff. I don't think we're going to put many Rico buildings down, but I mean, that's up for debate. We could always go back and actually do that later on. But we'll see how it feels. I don't know. When we place the zones down, we'll see what grows there, and we'll see how it all kind of works together. But that'll be in the live version. So right now I'm just kind of making these highways kind of meet up and look decent. And then I go in and I start to, what am I doing here? I make a cut through road here. The traffic around this area, I really want to keep flowing. And so we're gonna have one ways going in and out of this area just so there's not gonna be any traffic lights. So that's a little tip that I learned from One Way Bay, if you are a fan of that series that I did before, Northern Valley. And if you haven't, you can check it out if you want to. But yeah, you saw me, actually right now I'm trying to place this bridge, and I'd never placed that bridge before, so I didn't know what it was all about. So I placed it down and it wasn't gonna fit here, but it will fit somewhere else. And I put a little walkway over this for the people who park here. And now I'm just kind of going through and trying to figure out what pillars we could use down here. I mean, the normal ones are cool and all, but I have so many of these that I've downloaded. Why not try to use them? So I actually do find something that looks kind of unique and kind of cool and place them down. And then we get to detailing, of course. This took a little while, and you'll see me kind of go through it. I'm only going to, in the time lapse, show you the one side of this, but yes, putting these bushes in, I took these bushes from these side parking lots, and I just tried to keep influence from that and make this look kind of interesting, kind of like it was all designed to be together here. And in the end, I think it comes out fairly nice. And the funny thing is, on the bushes that I just placed down in that triangle area, I wanted to do like a white, red, purple, or pink, and then red, white, and I accidentally put another, like an extra purple in there. So a little, I guess, Easter egg kind of thing. I don't think many of you guys would have noticed it if I hadn't mentioned it. So there's that. You'll see me using this PLT mod. I think it is a PLT, prop line tool. And yeah, I tried to get this to work in my favor here, and it, for the most part, it did. And then for the last little bush in here, I tried to just go in here and kind of, I guess, even out the space in between it all. But yes, we'll spawn in here and we'll go back live and do some actual building in here. And we're gonna actually try to figure this part of the map out. All right, so we are back in our brand new contrasted color correction. Hope some of you guys are gonna like this. I hope all of you guys actually like this because it's really not that bad. It's definitely different than what we have been seeing, but you know what? It probably adds a little bit more, I think, life to the area, I guess you could say that. Because as I said before, we were going for more of a little like washed out look because it was supposed to be like a really cold environment, but now it's, I don't know. It's still, I think we can still achieve that. But anyway, here we are back at this square area, this new little thing, and you can see all of these bushes. Aren't they beautiful? And look, there's flowers in here, and they mixed all the colors of these bushes, and it all ties together, and these nice little bushes here. I don't know what those are called. And look, some trees. And then on the other side, yes, the same thing. But, you know, it took so long to do this right. But it does look really cool, and I cannot wait till both of these sides have buildings on them. So actually, you know what? Let's just go ahead and do that right now. Let's start zoning this. We clearly have the demand for this, so we are going to be able to fulfill some of this. I think we may want to put a gas station here, though. Like I said earlier, maybe we won't do any Rico stuff over here, and then I instantly decide we should put a gas station here. But anyway, I'm not really sure if anything's going to build over here for now, and I do want to keep like this road here and this space clear, because I think we are going to actually go ahead and build a road into this area, probably like this. And then out from this area, we'll do something like this, I guess. And I don't want any street lights around here, so that's why I'm kind of doing it this way. And then over here, it's a little iffy. It is a little iffy, but yeah, I don't know. To get back over here, you have to go like around here, and oh man, the one-way situation. I forgot how fun that is. One-way bay. These memories are coming out right now. But anyway, while I'm here and while I'm looking in this direction and while I remember it, let's go over and check out this interchange, because this, I think, is really what inspired the rocks over by that service plaza. I placed this rock and I put some shrubbery around it and had some trees growing out of it, like out of these little dirt areas, which I think really suits what this whole area well. And it's just a little subtle something. It's not, I mean, it is celebrated because there are bushes going around it, and all of these trees look like they were, like, intentionally planted in a line, but it's just a little something-something. It's nothing that, like, drivers are gonna want to have to, like, drive by to see, but it's just there to add a little flair to this area. And that last word didn't rhyme, but I tried. Anyway, this was not changed at all. Well, I think I may have put a line of bushes down here. It's still a little bland, but it's not that bad. I am kind of considering maybe taking all of these, like, roadside streetlights out from around here. I think these big overpass airport lights may be enough to light this area, but then again, I haven't seen it at night yet. I turned the night cycle off, the day-night cycle off, because I've been doing a ton of building. So, okay, what do we have over here right now? Oh, you know what? This wasn't supposed to be on this set of roads. Although this doesn't look all that bad. I just wish the shop faces were on the main street as opposed to the side streets. So you know what? I think we are going to delete this and just kind of take that off like that. And then this one is here correctly. And it's the same building, actually. But it does look really good over here. And wow, this must be the Art Deco pack right here, because that is like an old school ice cream parlor. And it looks awesome. Look at that. What is it called? Bob's Grind. Yeah, I don't want to know what's going on in there, but we do have the Big Bite and a couple things that have been here forever, and then of course the Down and Out Burger. And actually, look at that, a little growable gas station. That's actually kind of nice, because I was going to plop a gas station over here if I can find it. It's, I think, in this. Yes. And then have we done a Shell station yet? Not sure, but we will now. Over in the other part of town, did we do a Shell? I don't think we did. I think we did like a BP, and that's a BP, and then what is this, a Texaco? So yeah, there we go. That's all settled. This area over here is nice and kind of situated at this point, although there aren't really any workers to go over here, apparently. Not enough educated workers. Can I get rid of, yes. These little descriptions from this mod pop up, and they never make any sense, so I read them, and I'm like, ugh. I'm just gonna hide those. Oh, actually, we need to supply some power over here and probably somehow get some power over here. And yeah, we're gonna have to do that somehow, maybe discreetly if we can. I love this little power thing here because we can put it along the road and it looks like it's meant to be there and it's servicing this area, so that's nice. And this whole thing looks awesome. It came out really well. And I really like the detail work behind here. This is like a construction elevator, but I just placed it on the backside because it kind of looks like something that would be back here. Kind of like an antenna array, maybe, or something. And it's just that subtle little thing. And I also found this little fire escape ladder stairway thing. It just adds a little bit of flair back here. This is really cool back here. I love how this came out. And I wouldn't change it for anything. And I just, like, look, there's a little guardrail here to make sure that nobody comes flying in from this way and, like, crashes into an ambulance that our mechanics had just painstakingly taken so much time to fix because someone, you know, bled all over the back and it got in the electrical or something. But anyway, that was a tangent. Let's go back to this area. We need to get water over here. And we're actually kind of high up on demand right now for the industrial, which is interesting because I thought most of that stuff over by the dam is industrial. So we're gonna have to figure that one out. I do have, if I go into Rico, I have a ton of these buildings here that we actually did use over at the dam, but I think they're supposed to be like a big car factory. So I'm thinking maybe we'll end up putting like a car factory in around here or something and then having like rail to deliver all of the cars, the newly made cars to the, I guess, people of neighboring cities. And can we imagine that One Way Bay is like a neighboring city? I think a lot of the fans of that series will support that. And I just noticed that there are actually a ton of trees that are still in the river over here. I don't know why. I didn't place those. Those came with it. And actually, while I'm here, check it out. New water texture. It looks pretty cool. I think it does change from like slow flowing water over to like more rapid flowing water. You can see here, if I go into the, I think, electrical or this thing. Yes, this is, I think, maybe I'm reading this wrong, but this looks like it's more flow over here and then over here for sure. And then you get this like more of a ripple texture, or maybe it's just the direction that the water's flowing. I'm not really sure, but either way, it makes for a nice little contrast, so I'm really digging the updates to this texture pack. And of course, you can find this in the mod and asset list, which I did update, I'm pretty sure I got everything up to date now from this build so far, so you can go ahead and check all of that out. The link, as always, is in the description. Holy crap, we actually have a major fire at the dam. So luckily there's a wall of water behind it, so if it all goes bad, we can just break the dam and put this fire out. And it looks like all of the guys from the local fire department have now fixed it, and it should be fine. I don't think, do I have to like replace this? I don't think so. I think it'll just rebuild itself. It didn't like, it's not abandoned, but there are issues over here still, and too few services. What does that mean? Noise complaint, pollution, service progress is like very small. I guess maybe we should think about putting like a police station over here or something just to service that area. Not really sure. Maybe just like a small little something, like a little fire or a little police department just to like have over here. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe just right here? Can we do that? No, we can't. I don't know. Maybe we'll do it right over here. Sure, for now. Just to make that happy, maybe, if it went out that far. It doesn't look like it did, though. And no, I don't know. Anyway, you know what? We'll just delete this for now. It's just not going to serve any purpose. But let's get back over here because we still need to get these guys some electricity, which is fun. I don't really want to wind all of these power lines over here. So maybe I'll just go ahead and place some of these like, or you know what? No, for now we'll just connect it up with the power lines if I can find them. There they are. It'll go down this area along this like winding road here for now. It's all temporary. I'm gonna actually go through and delete this later, which is why I'm just gonna kind of put it up over this hillside and then back down to here. And is that enough? Of course not. Why would it be? Nothing's ever simple. There we go. We're connected up to the grid now in the most roundabout possible way. But anyway, it's not that bad. And then we... Why is this... Okay. Strange. There we go. That's all done. And so, yes, my theory... This thing just stays around sometimes, and I'm not exactly sure why it does, but... Oh, there it goes. Cool. My theory here is that people who want to come down to these shops will be able to park in the middle and then take these really awesome bridge that actually, I think, resorted back to the normal pillars. I'm not sure why that is. It's kind of a bummer. It looks like it's only happening on the pedestrian paths, though. But anyway, that kind of sucks. But anyway, these people will then be able to walk across the street here, and this was not actually supposed to be a lit intersection. An intersection with a light on it. Let's just take that off there. And then... Yes, everything looks good there. And so, all right, the last thing I want to do here right now in this episode is kind of figure out a way to get this street to hook up to this bridge, because that's really the last thing that we need to do. So what I'm kind of thinking here is, how am I going to do this? Okay, if I pause the game and I just delete this, and then I go ahead and take this one-way, three-lane road out a little bit farther. Just like this and this. And then I can make this into a one-way, two-lane. And then I'm thinking that this is going to be a six-lane road. And you know what? We'll stick to it and we'll drag this across over here like so. And then I think we'll try to get it right into this middle part here. And of course, it's not actually going to fit in the middle. So I guess maybe we'll take this down to a four lane and it still isn't going to fit in the middle. So maybe that plan's not going to work so well. Well, you know what? We can just eyeball it and do this like this. So there we go. And before I do that, I kind of want to make this into the six lane again. And we'll fix that up in a second, but this is the general theme of what I want to do here, and that is to make this kind of curve around like that, and then back around like that? Although that didn't go really well. There we go, that looks a little better. And yes, cool. Although, should we keep it like that? I think we should. And if I do this, is it gonna... It's not gonna create a light. So, there we go. That's all linked up. Really cool. Well done. Well done, me, I think. Maybe not. I do want to clean this curve up just a little bit now. Not much for you guys to comment on, I guess, in this one. Although, I do want to explain what I want to do over here. And maybe you guys can provide a nickname for this little area, this little square. It's still in, I believe, Walton Ridge. Although, half of it's in Evergreen Park, and we actually have to go through and sort that out. And the other half is in Walton Ridge, which is kind of interesting. It's kind of weird, but anyway. This area over here, this beautiful, like, view of the waterfalls, of the Twin Falls over here, I downloaded a bunch of Rico condos over here, and this is going to be kind of cool. Well, something like this. So, I don't know about you guys, but I've seen, like, little condo developments, little parks with condos in them. When I say park, I mean, like, a little road network with condos in it. And we'll be able to do that along this coast of this area. We'll be able to build this out into something kind of cool, and we'll be able to probably do some sort of, like, path work maybe around here, or maybe even just putting the key walls up. And it's gonna be a really cool, like, little area where they, if you had, like, a room right here, imagine this being your room, or this is the view from your bedroom. How awesome would that be? Like, rent per month out the yin yang. It's gonna be expensive. But yeah, this is going to be a really cool little area, and I'm thinking that the shopping area down here, it's already bustling with, like, people. Really awesome, and yes, I can't wait to see how this all develops. So I think we're going to do that in the next episode, and then when we get some more demand for residential, we'll be able to fill out this little development over here and maybe do some more stuff around here, although... Not sure, I might just cover this with trees and call it, because that is quite the steep slope there. But, alright, I'm gonna wind this episode down. It was actually kind of a longer one, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. I'm sorry for the wait. Like I said, I've had such a long week already, and I just haven't had the time to sit down and finish this. But we are going to probably, hopefully, get back on schedule on early week releases on this series, but... Yes, so yeah. Guys, if you like this one, give me a thumbs up. If you hated it, give me a thumbs down. And if you want to see more content more frequently, go ahead and head over to my Patreon page and give me a little bit of a donation per month, because that would actually help me out a ton to be able to actually have some more time to do this kind of stuff. So, guys, I'll see you back here in Northern Bay for the next episode. And until then, have a good one.